The Easter story you're about to hear is so amazing that it's almost too good to be true. But it is true. In fact, the miracle of the resurrection is one of the most well-documented facts in history. Doubters have never been able to explain how else Jesus' body could have disappeared from the tomb.
That's because it's kind of hard to explain away the earthquake and the angel who announced that Jesus was not there but had risen.
It's just like a mystery story come to life.
Good choice of words, since that's exactly what Jesus did.
Have you seen him with your very own eyes?
No, but Jesus did appear to more than 300 people after he rose from the dead.
Wow, that's a lot of eyewitnesses. Sounds amazing.
It is amazing that Jesus came back from the dead, but it really did happen. All the stories in the Bible about Jesus are true.
Well, tell me more.
Can you remember any stories in the Bible about Jesus and children?
Well, I remember the story of the boy who shared his loaves and fishes, and Jesus fed 5,000 people.
Good. Does anyone remember any other stories?
I remember the story of the 12-year-old girl that Jesus raised from the dead.
Oh, yes, the daughter of Jairus. Any others?
My favorite story is where the children got to sit in Jesus' lap.
I found it in the Bible. Suffer the little children to come unto me, and forbid them not, for such is the kingdom of God. Verily I say unto you, whosoever shall not receive the kingdom of God as a little child, he shall not enter therein.
Wow, little kids become role models. I like that.
So you see, children are very important to Jesus.
I wish I could have sat in his lap.
I wish I could have seen Jesus with my very own eyes.
Well, we weren't born during Bible times, but Jesus didn't just die to save the people he knew while he was on the earth. Jesus paid for the sins of all the people in the world, past, present, and future. So everybody ought to love Jesus.
So, Jesus died on the cross for us. But then what?
Are you sure you're ready for the answer?
That's the part about the earthquake and the angel.
And the grave clothes with nobody in them? No body, get it? There was no body.
No body? But how did Jesus get out of the tomb?
Well, the answer's in Matthew 28. Will you read it for us?
In the end of the Sabbath, as it began to dawn toward the first day of the week, came Mary Magdalene and the other Mary to see the tomb. And behold, there was a great earthquake, for the angel of the Lord descended from heaven and came and rolled back the stone from the door and sat upon it. His countenance was like lightning, and his raiment white as snow. And for fear of him, the keepers did shake and became as dead men. And the angel answered and said unto the woman, Fear not ye, for I know that you seek Jesus, which was crucified. He is not here, for he is risen, as he said.
I wish I could have seen that with my very own eyes.
After all that, you'll think that everybody would understand who Jesus is.
Jesus was the greatest man who ever lived, wasn't he?
Well, yes, Jesus is the only person who never, ever sinned. That's because Jesus is more than just a man. Jesus is the Son of God who came to be the Savior of the world.
Yes, but a lot of people don't know that. I think we'd better start telling people.
Wow, that reminds me of the trickle-down theory. God loved us and sent His Son. We accept Him and tell our neighbors, who tell their neighbors, who tell their neighbors.
Who tell their neighbors, who tell their neighbors.
Till the whole world has heard the good news of Jesus.
I think I need a little help understanding which part of Easter is the miracle part. Is it that Jesus was willing to die in our place?
Well, I think the miracle is that Jesus rose again. Don't forget about the earthquake and the angel.
And nobody in the tomb.
I agree with both of you, but I'd have to add one more part of the miracle. You see, Jesus not only rose from the dead, but he ascended to heaven and sent back his Holy Spirit to empower and comfort us.
So, can we see him with our very own eyes?
No, but we can see him with our faith. Jesus lives in our hearts if we trust in him.
So, we can't see him, but we know he's here.
Exactly.
So that's the Easter miracle. Since Jesus rose from the dead, we have new life in him.